down a village resort also. If you guys are new to the whole Disney thing, this is where you're going to come to get on the buses. This is like the bus depot outside of Disney Springs. You'll notice all the buses got, well, some of them have the either the Disney theme on the outside of them, some of the movie themes, like the Monsters, Inc. right there. Some of them just have, like, the Pluto up there. They got the Pluto color and its decal up there. And some of them are just the regular Disney buses. It's a Walt Disney World bus, and that's, like, the one right in front of us right there. And up on top, it'll tell you where each bus is going. So you see that little light on the side there? And that one says the old refill. Fill their pixie dust right now, apparently. That usually means they're off duty. But we're right now located over behind the old Planet Hollywood building. And the Coca-Cola building. And up in front over there is going to be the garage where that bus is. You're going to walk out the garage, walk over here, and then you'll get on this bus or choose the bus you want to go to. They got a big old board that'll tell you every single resort you're going to. And this one's Animal Kingdom Lodge, located at number 23. So you jump on the bus and then you head on over. And we're just waiting to see if anyone else is going with us today. We're just hanging out here for a couple minutes. And if you guys aren't aware, right now it's just me shooting. Morgan and Marley are actually on vacation right now, so it's just going to be me today. They've been out a couple of times now, but they'll be back soon. And for now, it's just me shooting, so you'll have to bear with me while we're doing the video shoot today. But if you guys have any other places you want us to actually go and get a video of, just leave it down in the comments below. We're trying to expand on the channel this year, made a lot of modifications to it, trying to tweak out the little bugs so we can grow a little bit more. And from there, we'll just bang out what we can. Had a little bit of a cancer scare this year. That's why we're a little off to a little bit of a slow start. So I'm getting that taken care of, but apparently it's not gonna kill me, so that's a good thing. So we're gonna try to get out in moderation and do the videos, but we're on our way, guys. And now we're leaving. So apparently it's just me on the bus today, which makes for good filming. Parking garage one more time as we're leaving. And that's the orange parking garage. So there's three of them here. They're all labeled. You're going to park in either the lime garage or the orange garage. Try to get the old GoPro around. I'm using the old GoPro Eat today. And if you guys are coming down and using the old GoPros or your cameras and stuff, make sure you pick the one that fits you. Don't just go by what anyone says is the best thing down here to shoot. And some of them work a little bit better in low lighting. Some of them work a little bit better making the turns and the sudden movements. But find the one that's right for you. Our favorite's the GoPro Eat. Here's another look at one of the regular Walt Disney transportation buses. And here comes a Goofy bus. So they're all different. They got Frozen buses, they've got the Guardians of the Galaxy buses. And unfortunately, you gotta choose the bus that's going to where you're looking to go. Up in front, there's the Disney Springs Water Tower there. And in the distance, you're gonna see the balloon heading up. And we actually got one of them videos posted on the balloon. If you guys are looking to see that video or any video that we might have done, if you're not sure, just type, go on to YouTube, go up on top in your search bar there, type in where you're looking to go, like the Disney Springs balloon, and then type in Country Bear Tours at the end, and it'll show you all of our videos. So pretty much anything you want to see in Disney, if you're interested in looking at it in our channel, just type up what you're looking to see, and then at the end of it, type in Country Bear Tours, and it'll pull you to all our videos. We did have a website up. Hopefully this year we can get it posted back up. It's just a lot of time to maintain these things. And because most of you guys know, I also work a full-time job. So it's a hobby that takes a lot of time. So we're going to try to do what we can do to keep it running good and get the videos you guys want to see. Now we're waiting. waiting at the old red light. Try to get this camera around quick.
Way in the background there to the left now, but you never
never know anymore. You come down, you take a look at the resorts, and they're doing so much construction over here lately. You just gotta hope that what you're going to shoot is actually there. Then there's the Old Key West little tower there that they turned into a sign, but you see the Disney Vacation Club. It's actually the Disney Vacation Club tower. I call it the Old Key West Tower because it pretty much started with Old Key West. I remember them putting that up. It looks like they finally got the flag on top of the city almost perfectly straight for a change. For the longest time, that little red flag was always off to the side. And they've got on front of that, they've always got that little TV that changes. I'm not sure if I like that. I think it encourages accidents. A lot of people aren't from around here, so if you're paying attention to that sign and not driving, there's always a fender bender here. So be careful while you guys are driving your cars around. But anyway, we're on a bus today, so we're heading over to the Animal Kingdom Lodge, which is a Jambo house. And then you've got the Kidani Village located right to the right of that one. Or if you're looking at the resort, it's to the left. Now this is one of the means that you could get around here. You can either use your car or bus. A lot of times you can use the boats, monorails, just about anything you're looking for, but because we're going way out to the Animal Kingdom, the only thing that's going to get us out here is either our car or a bus. So we're on the bus today, taking it. And if you guys haven't ridden the buses, they're always fun to get on. I don't like them all the time, but they're fun to get on every now and then. A lot of times when it's really busy, try to be aware of the buses, because the buses get full of people, guys. And what that means is more bus stops, more time on the bus. So if you're looking to save a little time on your vacation and enjoy it more, you might want to get from point A to point B a little quicker. Alright, we took a right right there, so we're actually going to go. And there's many different ways to get to where you're going. We could have went straight, but right now we're taking a right and we're heading it out this way. But all the roads pretty much take you where you're going to go. You just got to know the roads. And they change them very quickly anymore around here, so you might have a road today and tomorrow it's gone, so. Over the years, it's always shortcuts that I've always known to take. And my boss is way back up, and when I was up in New York years ago, we always had a system that came down the old Bonnet Creek Road. It's always our shortcut, or the overpass road. And it took us over to Old Key West, and then they changed all that, so. I guess they make the roads a little more accommodating, so what you're used to may change, but just keep an eye on your roads, guys. And up on the right-hand side, you got Old Key West. I actually locked in the buy back in 1993. My boss actually got me interested in joining the Old Key West Club, and finally was able to buy in 96. It was a big decision back then, but now I wish I had bought a lot of them. And if you guys are looking at the timeshares down here, these are the only timeshares that you're ever going to buy that don't really depreciate. So you could go buy a regular timeshare somewhere to like go to Key West or whatever, the real Key West, and you'll never be able to get rid of your timeshare. Nobody wants it. But Disney timeshares are a little different. You're like pretty much guaranteed a sale if you want out of it, and they don't let them get sold for under a certain dollar amount. So if you want to sell it for less, you're not going to get allowed to get permission from Disney to sell that, which is nice because it keeps your timeshare always worth something, so you don't lose on it. But probably the best investment of my life was my timeshare in Old Key West. Back in the day, it used to be known as Cottage Flats, but now it's Old Key West. As I said in a video a while back, it's amazing because when I first started going to these timeshares, when the restaurants opened and you started going, I actually got to see several people that have retired because of going so long. And so you go into a restaurant over the years, like in Olivia's, and you see the different people that wait on your table, and it's amazing when you see them start, the day they start, they're new people, and then 20 years go by and these people are retiring, so. That's amazing. It's just, that's what I like to see. And when I originally bought, it was definitely a homey feeling when you're coming and going into the timeshares, because it gives you the feeling like you're, I guess, maybe a little more than you are in the world, but it's just a nice feeling. And anytime you let your timeshare out to one of your family members or friends, they always come back and say that's the one thing that they remember from the whole vacation that stands out. And that's getting told, you know, the welcome home when you're at the gate. They know your name, welcome home, and it's almost like that person visiting is the owner of the timeshare. So it's kind of a cool feeling, but I don't know, the different things I like over the years, you know, some things have gone away, but hopefully some of it will come back now. A lot of bad decisions have been made, but now's the chance, hopefully, to turn that around and fix it up. So a lot of change in leadership, but hopefully they can get it all running a little bit better and back to the normal. I'm going to try to turn my camera right now a little quicker. I don't know how it's going to take, but you got Epcot over there, so I want you guys to see the Epcot ball. You're going to see it in the break. Right in there, right over to the left, that's the Epcot ball. And that's like right next to, and next to that's the Guardians of the Galaxy, but that's right next to the Old Key West Resort. And over to the right of that, back behind these trees ahead of me, is going to be the Swan, the Dolphin. And you got the Swan Reserve. See if I can find it through the trees here for you. It should be straight ahead. Let's get a little break in the vegetation and see if we can see it. Looks like we got some clearance coming up over here. And it's the monorail out there. I don't know if you guys can see that concrete thing, but right where the Swan and Dolphin, way out there in the distance, you can see the Swan and the Dolphin off to the left of the big triangle building. Right there in front of us is the monorail. So that will take you over to Epcot, all the way over to the Magic Kingdom. As you can see, they're starting to implement a lot of solar on property. I'm going to turn my camera back the other way now. So this monorail track is going to take you all the way over to the Magic Kingdom. And I actually just rode that the other day, so I posted that video. Some of these bus rides are longer than others, depending on how far out they actually are. Now, some of them during the day, you've got to watch what you're going to go on or watch what you're looking to ride, because some of these buses actually have a bus stop. So if you're going through a resort and you want to go right to, like, Disney Springs, you may have to go to, like, 4 bus stops along the way, and that can take a lot of time, guys. So try to do some homework and ask questions. Always ask questions. It doesn't hurt. And over in the distance there, I don't know if you can see it, but there's the Beach Club Tower over there. And over in that direction, right there, see the big triangle building? To the left of that, it's going to be the boardwalk, the Swan, the Dolphin, you've got the Beach Club, the Villas, the Beach Club Villas, and then you've got the Yacht Club. And I don't know if most of you guys know, but if you look at any of the maps, you've got the Old Key West side with the Disney Springs looking straight down on a map at them, and then down below you've got the Magic Kingdom. Off to the upper right, you've got the Animal Kingdom. If you look at it, it actually resembles a Mickey head. And right there is the Swan Reserve. We actually have that posted. I'm going to get in there soon and do another shoot of that. But that, if you guys want to see that one, you're just going to go to the Swan Reserve and then Country Bear Tours. It'll take you to show you ours. If you guys like any of the videos that we're posting or you want to see more, definitely turn around and send us some comments down below, guys. We really appreciate the comments. We're trying to do as much of the shooting as we can. We get a lot of different requests, so we got to try to get it all together. I don't want to be going from one end of the Disney to the other just to shoot a little video. So we try to get them all on different days when we're in that area. But comments are definitely helpful. We like the watching. Share if you can. Like the videos. It's the only way we're going to grow. The more we grow, the more time I can spend here. So I'd like to get this to be my full-time, pretty much, thing to do instead of having to work a job on top of this. But y'all gotta start somewhere, and we do bang the pavement pretty hard. So if you guys want to see a video, post it down in the comments. We'll go shoot it. Don't worry about it being just an arcade. You want an arcade, we'll shoot an arcade. You want a pool, we'll shoot a pool. We've been trying to get a lot of the music out there because a lot of people want us to post the area loop music, but we're getting a lot of copyright issues with that, so I've been kind of working and fighting with YouTube about that. Had some touchy-feely situations with that whole mess, but we'll see what we can keep getting posted out there for you. And if you want to see our videos with the music, just type up, the Barnstormer area music, Country Bear Tours. So everything has just got Country Bear Tours on it, and it'll take you to any of our videos. That way you get to see what we have posted out there. Like I said, we did have a website. We're going to get it posted out there again. So this way, on the front page, you just click either park, rides, restaurants, pools, and it'll take you where you want to go. So it's a lot easier than trying to go through YouTube and find your videos. But we're still driving, so the Animal Kingdom Lodge is a little ways out there, and then next to that, you can either stay at the Animal Kingdom Lodge, which is Jamba House, or walk over to the Kidani Village. And I don't mind a walk, I like to walk, but we're almost there, so we'll get back to the video, guys. Thank you. road straight past that little green sign there. You'll keep going straight, and that'll take you right around to the Kadani Village. There's our sign for the
Jambo House.
Jambo, everyone. Like I said, if you continue down that road right there, it's going to bring you over to the Kadani Village. But we're getting off here, and we're going to walk in and shoot this resort for you today. We've been getting a lot of requests to get these resorts shot again, so we're going to get out there in moderation and get them done. I don't want to overdo it. You got to watch out for the sun nowadays. I guess that is what contributed to getting a little bit of skin cancer, so I got to take care of myself a little better. But here we are, guys, the Jambo House.